Dear viewers of the Tom Photo channel, I started wondering which f-stops I most commonly use with my lenses. I suspected that I primarily use them wide open for good bokeh, stopped down for landscapes, or occasionally at their sweet spot values for maximum sharpness. I thought I didn't use the intermediate f-stops much. Let's find out if that is true. I analyzed around 28,000 of my best photos taken with 12 different lenses, mostly my Fuji lenses, but a few Nikons as well, and roughly 10 different cameras. To do this, I used my own Python script to automatically retrieve the EXIF data from the photos. I've included the script in the text box below in case you're interested in using it. It comes with basic instructions in the header. Feel free to check it out. The first lens is the Fuji XF 18-55 kit lens. I've used this lens extensively, especially for all-purpose photography. The histogram shows how often I've used each f-stop. The occurrences are on the y-axis and the f-stops are on the x-axis. The numbers above the bars represent the f-stops. This figure highlights my use of intermediate f-stops. I seem to favor the f8 to f10 range for maximum sharpness. I also display the lens sharpness graph for you, so you can see how sharpness works with this lens. The dip in sharpness at longer focal lengths is noticeable, and I see it every time with this lens. For more information, see the links below. Today I'm showing sharpness profiles from my previous videos, but won't spend much time discussing them. The links will take you to the full discussions. Based on this f-stop profile, you can probably tell that this is my travel lens. And I rarely use it in low light conditions. I mainly use it for street photography and landscapes on the go. Next up is the Fuji XC 16-50 version 2. This lens should have a similar profile because I use it for similar purposes. However, the popular f-stops are shifted slightly to the left. Most notably, I seem to use this lens more in low light, as you can see from the frequent use of f3.5. I carry this lens with me daily, and I also rely on it in challenging conditions. However, it's not made for that. While the previous lens was used for ideal travel conditions, this is my all-weather lens. The sharpness profiles are provided here as a reference. They look flatter at the beginning. Feel free to pause the video if you want to take a closer look at these profiles. Since we are on the topic of kit lenses, let's also consider the Fuji XC 15-45mm kit lens. This lens is a marvel. I love using it when I need a compact package or a wide-angle shot. As you can see from the f-stop usage, this is predominantly an f8 lens for me, typically for wide landscape photography. The sharpness profile varies significantly depending on the focal length. Once again, this profile comes from another video dedicated entirely to this lens. This is also why the figure styles are different for different lenses, and I'm sorry about that. Now let's move on to some telephoto zooms. The Fuji XF 55-200 is an outstanding lens for wildlife photography. At 200mm, the lowest f-stop is 4.8, and this is well represented in the graph. While I've taken some landscape shots using a tripod, I primarily use this lens to photograph wildlife. The sharpness profile shows that this lens performs better wide open than stopped down, which is a bit weird. I make it a habit to determine the sharpness profile for every lens that I own, and I've included them in my previous videos. For a short time, I used the Fuji XC 50-230mm telephoto zoom lens. At 230mm, the best f-stop is 6.7, which is evident in the graph. I have favored f6.7 whenever possible, with f8 being another commonly used value, indicating that I use the lens for landscapes. The sharpness profile shows significant variations at different focal lengths. Overall, the XC 50-230 is a budget-friendly lens that delivers a lot of value for the price. Let's now move on to the Fuji prime lenses. First up is the XF 23mm f1.4R, an incredibly versatile lens and one of my latest acquisitions. I use it primarily for photographing children or cat at home, often in low light situations, which explains why I mostly shoot at f1.4. The peak at f2.8 probably corresponds to group photos where I want several people in reasonable focus. f6.4 might be used for occasional landscape in low light. The sharpness profile of this lens shows an interesting hump. The optical qualities of this lens are easy to love. The Fuji XF 27mm pancake lens is special and a joy to use for street photography. It's sharp, wide open and versatile at any f-stop. The histogram shows how often I use it in low light situations. The peak at f6.4 is again prominent, and I use this lens similarly to the XF 23mm lens. Its sharpness profile is also very comparable to the XF 23, but with a smaller hump. The Fuji XF 35mm R is very dear to me. It has a retro character but delivers excellent sharpness, and it's probably my favorite focal length. As expected, I mostly use it wide open, rarely choosing intermediate f-stops. The f5.6 peak likely reflects medium-range handheld landscape photos. The sharpness profile once again shows that familiar hump, which seems to be a trend among certain Fuji primes. The Fuji XF 56mm f1.2R is my brightest, sharpest, and probably most remarkable lens. It's an exceptional portrait lens with beautiful bokeh. As you can see from my usage, I tend to shoot wide open at f1.2 almost exclusively. While it can certainly handle landscapes, its main appeal is in its wide open capabilities. If you don't own this lens yet, I highly recommend it. It's truly wonderful. Its sharpness profile is unsurprising once you've seen those of the other Fuji primes. I've used my Fuji X10 for many years. Its non-interchangeable lens is fantastic, and I appreciate all of its f-stops. This lens performs well wide open and offers excellent characteristics. Here's its sharpness profile. In general, it performs superbly wide open and gradually loses sharpness as it's stopped down. I've analyzed this unique lens in depth in other videos, all of which are linked below. Finally, let's look at some Nikon lenses. The AF-S 50mm f1.8G is a legend that I frequently use with my Nikon D610 and D3400. The sharpness profile shows that this lens improves as you stop it down almost in a linear fashion, though I mostly use it wide open for bokeh. When I don't shoot at f1.8, I'm equally likely to use any other f-stop. Even I was surprised by this graph. The Tamron 90mm macro prime lens is my go-to for macro photography with the Nikon D3400. While I often want good bokeh, it's not a challenge with macro photography because the focal plane is so thin. For macro work, I aim for the largest possible f-stop, and f8 is a reliable value, especially for photographing insects. I often need to use a flash to get enough light though. This lens has been featured extensively in my other videos, and its sharpness profile shows a mountain-like shape. If you have enough light, f-stops near 10 are the best. So yes, apparently I do use intermediate f-stops with some lenses, especially zooms and for macro work. However, my primes are mostly reserved for good bokeh and low light, and I tend to shoot them wide open. After all, if you're paying for a wide aperture, you might as well use it. Thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments how you use your favorite lenses. If I didn't bore you, please consider subscribing and liking. I hope to see you again in my other videos. Goodbye.